It is now time for Broken on Times Radio.
If ever you are in doubt, remember what mama told me, brown skin girl, your skin just like pearls.
Wow, I like this. This looks good. Dressing to kill.
Katsigana, this is not fashion. This is madness. I can see 3/4 of your thigh. Is that what you want people to see?
And you call that madness?
I think it is.
Sandra, madness is subjective. All people are mad. What differs is the degree of the madness. I call this freedom of dress. You see, my life is not a product of public opinion. It is my life.
Mm-hmm. But you don't exist on an island. Your dressing paints a picture of who you are, and the importance of image in a society cannot be underrated.
But I simply do not care what people think about me. We live in a male-dominated society which imposes high, unrealistic moral standards for women, and I don't like that.
Hey, okay, Misha. Choose what pleases you.
I surely will, my dear. It is my life, my body, and my taste.
Someone is calling you.
Eish, I'm not going to answer.
Who is it?
It's John.
Why wouldn't you want to answer your husband's call?
Kufuna, eish.
Linda? Linda, can you come here, please?
Eish, what is it?
Can you take a seat?
Here we go again. It's like every meeting with you is a court session.
Linda, why do you have this attitude towards me? Huh? A bad attitude is a spoiler in any relationship.
Well, our relationship is already spoiled, don't you think?
Linda, what is this?
Where did you find it?
Well, the means of discovery are not relevant right now. What is this?
Like, what were you doing in my bag?
Well, it is obvious that you have an affair going on with your boss. It is your choice, Linda. As you often say it is your life.
John, please listen. Kevin is just a friend.
Oh.
We joke around and play husband and wife jokes, but nothing serious. It's like you think all I do is think about men.
Linda, this note says, thanks, dear, for the lunch. You continue to plant sweet memories in my life. I look forward to going to work because of you. Can't wait for more. Does this sound like language that a manager should be sending to his married female juniors at work? Huh?
Is this why you called me?
Linda, I didn't call
this
you because
nonsense.
Of that.
Then why did you call me?
I have cancer.
What? You went to get the results today? I'm sorry, I forgot.
The same time you were probably buying lunch for your boss boyfriend, I was receiving news that I have prostate cancer. I tried to call you several times, but now I know why you couldn't answer me. But it is all right. I'll be dead soon. You can have all the men you want in the world.
Once upon a time, you were 25. Walking up the aisle, you made the promise of your life. Blinked twice and you were 29. Singing lullabies.
Hello?
Sandra, I need you in my office.
I have a few things I'm working on and...
Sandra, I need you in my office now.
I'll be there, sir. I'm here, sir.
Sandra, do you know that everybody is complaining about you?
What do you mean?
I mean just that. Did you slap Mr. Pensulo, the security guard, last night?
I did, but he's a foolish man who wanted to tell me what to do with my car, as if he has ever even driven a car before.
You reported late last week for the Zoom meeting with our international partners.
I did, sir. I had a problem with my laptop.
Why didn't you use your phone, knowing the importance of your role in that meeting?
I didn't think about it.
And what is this I'm hearing about your daily fights with Brandina from the finance department?
I cannot allow the finance department to bully me and jeopardize my work. That is exactly what people in finance do. They want to be felt by everybody around here.
Sandra, listen to me. Your attitude stinks. I'm afraid that despite your individual brilliance as an engineer, your people skills are deplorable. Teamwork is crucial for our success in this company. I cannot allow any one person to demoralize everybody. I will have to let you go.
Sir, you can't do that.
Why not?
There are labor laws that prevent general managers like you from firing people willy-nilly.
Sandra, do you know that you could be prosecuted for slapping the guard?
I know.
So before you file your complaints with the industrial court, give us the opportunity to report your case to the police and then see what the law says about slapping co-workers willy-nilly.
I'm sorry. I need this job.
It's too late, Sandra. This is your last month at this place. A formal letter will be at your desk by the end of business hours today.
No.
It was personally a pleasure working with you, but for the common good of this company, I do have to let you go. Good morning, Sandra.
Once upon a time, Sandra, I need to talk to you about John. He has refused to take chemotherapy. He says he'd rather die than face the torture of life.
Imane Odinkani?
What?
Linda, you can finally be free. You have always talked about how you wish you could be free from male domination in your life. There are many wives out there who wish their husbands could just vanish into the thin air.
But for the first time, I've started to think about my life. I don't think I've been a good wife to him.
Says who?
Says a voice within me.
Voice within me? My foot. Mwayambalidi, nukumva a voice within, Godi?
You don't understand, Sandra. I know where I've been and what I've done. For some reasons, I never paid a thought about the life I was living. But now I feel a heavy load upon my heart. I mean, John has money. He could have chosen to fly to India for treatment. But he doesn't want any medical intervention. He says the joy he has in the Lord is greater than the prospect of his physical suffering and death. If I were in his shoes, I'd be bitter, but he's not. Maybe this whole thing about Jesus is real.
Linda, please, let's not get there. You want us to start dancing to hymns and praying on top of our lungs? Giving our money to useless pastors in the name of offering? Can't you see how miserable a lot of churchgoers are? Girl, spare us from this church madness.
Let me ask you a question, Sandra. Are you happy? Would you say that you are genuinely happy?
No. I'm not. As a matter of fact, I lost my job this morning. I didn't know how to tell you because you've been warning me about my attitude.
I can't believe you.
Why would I lie to you? I may even be prosecuted for slapping a security guard. I'm doing handovers beginning tomorrow even.
I'm sorry to hear this, my friend.
I'll be all right. I need my freedom more than I need a job.
But this is exactly what I'm saying, Sandra. We may appear happy, but the truth is we are empty inside. There is a lot of bitterness in us. I, for one, truly need help.
From who? These lousy psychologists and pastors?
But maybe we don't need help from man. Our problems are deeper than what man can handle.
Linda, what is going on with you?
Come on, Sandra, open your eyes. Our life is a lie.
It's hard to see.
I call this freedom of dress. You see, my life is not a product of public opinion.
Did you slap Mr. Pensulo, the security guard, last night?
He's a foolish man who wanted to tell me what to do with my car.
It's like every meeting with you is a court session.
Linda, why do you have this attitude towards me?
Our life is a lie.
Dear Linda, doctors have given me a few weeks to live. I could depart from this life any day, but I'm not afraid to die. I have reconciled my life with my Maker, and I'm looking forward to meeting Him face to face. Let me take this opportunity to thank you for the 3 years that you have been my wife. You are the woman God gave me, and I'm grateful for that. I know you have done so much to compromise my faith in the Lord. Your affairs, your lack of submission, your deception, and sometimes violent language left huge scars in my life. But in everything, I choose to be thankful. I wish you all the best, Linda. Enjoy life. John.
It's hard to see the storm blowing over anytime soon. It's hard to hear any hope in the headlines or how to know what's true. We've been trusting in the broken to make us whole.
May I be of help to you, ladies?
We need help, Abusa. I'll not beat about the bush. Our lives are messed up. I just buried my husband to cancer. I'll be very honest to say that I contributed to his death. But I do not want to continue living life like before. I feel so empty.
It's true. I recently lost my job. The truth be told, I deserved to be chopped. I was ungrateful, rude, and uncooperative. Life has all been about me. I don't want to continue living like that.
A broken heart, God will not despise. No one is too far gone from the hand of salvation. I'm glad that you guys came. And about your late husband? He paid me a visit before he died.
Abusa, I have one wish. And one wish only for my wife and her best friend. That they know Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior. They live a high but empty life. What they call enjoyment is merely a recipe for destruction.
I can't live like this anymore.
Neither can I.
This is the best decision that you have ever made in your life. And you will not regret it. Life without Jesus is not worth living. Let us pray.
This week's episode of Broken was written and directed by Vianna Chunga. The part of John was played by Anko Seunda. The part of Linda was played by Cindy Nyoni. The part of Sandra was played by Tabisile Kamangala. The part of General Manager was played by Chisomo Chinyama. The part of Abusa was played by Vianna Chunga. Broken theme instrumental was played by Faith Musa. Studio recording was done by Christopher Nkosi. Editing and production was done by Z Chunga. Be there same time next week for another episode of Broken.